Hi, and welcome to another episode of Annie Never Fucking Learns When It Comes to Boys. So if you go through my other fuckboy story times, you'll notice that all of them were from a couple years ago that they happened. But today's story is actually very fresh. It happened a couple weeks ago and I'm still kind of like hurt financially and emotionally. But I don't know, I feel like YouTube is kind of like my therapy and talking about it just kind of makes me feel better. But before I get into it, I just want to shout out today's top comments, which are these two people. And what it basically means is if you comment something on my most recent video and I like it, then I'll feature you and shout you out in my next video. So if you want to be featured in my next week's video, just comment something down below and maybe I'll pick you. So for the people who follow me on Instagram, and if you don't, like, what are you doing? Pause right now and follow me. I'll link it down below. You're welcome. But for the people who do follow me, you will have known that I went to LA in April time. And it was basically my best friend's 21st birthday. And I was always taught to treat my friends the way I want to be treated. You know, it's a special occasion. 21 is a big deal. So I thought, you know what? I'm gonna treat my best friend and pay for her plane ticket to go with me to LA. So that's what I did. I've been working full-time for a year because I've been on my year abroad, so I had some money, but again, I need to save because I'm going into my last year of university. This will all become a little bit more relevant, but I had some money, but not a lot. I'm not sure if she wants me to use her real name, so I'll use the name Karen. me and Karen, we touched down into LA, checked into Airbnb, and at the time she was kind of talking to a guy that she met a year before because she'd been to LA before, and they'd been talking for a whole year. So the next day we kind of settled in, and the guy that she'd been talking to decided to drop by our Airbnb, and he happened to bring a friend. At first I didn't really think much of the friend, and it was kind of like almost like a little bit of a group date, like Karen and her guy, and then her guy's friend was meant for me, I guess. And at first I didn't really think much of the friend. When they both left, I remember Karen asking me like, oh, you and, let's call him Kentucky, you and Kentucky really got on really well, like, what do you think of him? And I remember just saying like, no, he's nice, but I'm not really interested. I don't really care what people look like. What I tend to go for is their personality, so it will never be a case where I'll just instantly start liking someone because I can't instantly get to know their personality, if that makes sense. So at the time I was just like, no, I'm not really feeling it. He's not really someone I would go for. But what ended up happening was because Karen and her guy hung out with each other every day, it got really intense, and I ended up seeing Kentucky along with his friend every single day for the 2 weeks that I was in LA. And like I said, it was very intense, and I guess when you see someone every single day, all day, you get to know them a lot quicker and things developed a lot quicker. So we ended up, I don't even know, you know when you're kind of like, you're not official, you're not boyfriend and girlfriend, but you're not talking to other people, like you're not dating other people, and you've kind of talked about being together. We were at that stage already, like 2 weeks into knowing each other. I'm getting ahead of myself. So basically, one of the first red flags with this guy was when I met up with him at the Grove. LA people, I guess you'll know where that is. It's basically just a massive shopping center. It was like 26 degrees, it was hot. And this guy came out with a hoodie. And I looked at him and I was just like, you need to go, why? So he basically wore a hoodie, wore nothing underneath, and he was boiling. And it was making me feel uncomfortable. So I was like, hey, let's go get you a t-shirt or something, cause you're gonna get a heat stroke otherwise. So we go into Topshop and I just find him like just a normal white cotton t-shirt for $20. And we head to the till, and that's when he goes, oh wait, no, I forgot my wallet. And I was just like, you know, we've been hanging out for a while now, it's very intense between us, we've already told each other we like each other, I don't mind paying for you, like, you've forgotten your wallet, there's nothing you can do. So I go, oh no, it's fine, like, I'll get it for you, I don't mind. Like, you'll feel so much better if you just wear the t-shirt outside. And he goes, oh, thank you so much. And then looks to the side and goes, oh, but what about that shirt over there? and points to like a David Bowie t-shirt, and it's a little bit more expensive than the original shirt, and I was just like, oh, I don't know, like, if someone offers you to buy something, you don't just point to something more expensive. Like, I'm known for ignoring red flags, so I was like, oh, okay, yeah, that's fine, because in my mind, and I think any other rational person would have assumed that he'd either pay me back or return the favor, because we would always go out and eat. So I thought, okay, well, he'll probably like cover me when we go eat something. That's fine. I don't mind doing that. So I get him the shirt, he gets changed, he feels so much better. And that's when we meet up with my friend Karen, and he suggests to go eat something. This is within 30 minutes of me getting him the shirt. So I obviously think, oh, because he's suggesting we go eat, he must at least have enough money to pay for himself, surely, because surely you wouldn't suggest to go eat when you don't have any money, right? So we go to Chipotle. It was my first time in Chipotle. I get my food. I was the first in line. I got a burrito bowl. It was great. Pay for my food, and I wait for Kentucky's food to come along to the cashier so he can pay for his stuff. So the cashier types in whatever, tells him the price. And this guy literally turns around, looks at me, and I'm just like, what? And he doesn't say anything. He doesn't say, oh, can you pay for me? Can you, like, I don't have my wallet, blah, blah, blah. He doesn't say anything. He just looks at me expectantly. Honestly, so shocked that I panicked. Like, I felt, quite honestly, I felt embarrassed because the cashier was looking at me weird. Nearly said his real name. Kentucky looked at me weird. I was just like, oh, I guess I'm paying for him too. And I paid for his food because, I don't know, I'm an idiot. So that kind of rubbed me the wrong way. I really didn't like what he did, but I thought I'd let it go because, again, I thought, okay, we eat out all the time. He's gonna pay for something for me, surely. I'm not the type of person who's like, oh, by the way, you owe me £11.52 exactly, you know? For me, it's just the gesture. So he didn't even have to return the same amount of money. It's just the gesture of him maybe paying for me, if that makes sense. I know it makes sense. So we went back to his place. I was really hungry, and I've never had a taco in my life. And there was a bunch of taco trucks all around LA. And Kentucky was just like, oh my god, like, you need to try a taco for the first time. Like, I want you to try your first taco with me. So that's when I decided to test him. Let's go get some tacos then. He gets up and then I'm like, oh, I'm quite tired though. Can you get me some? Because one taco is literally a dollar. So because that day I literally spent like $40, maybe $50 on him already, the least he could do is buy me a $1 taco, you know? So that's what I was trying to test, like, because he didn't have to pay me the exact amount, it's just the gesture. So he gets up, my friend Karen gets up as well because she wanted to get some tacos for herself and her guy because they'd kind of been treating each other. They come back 10 minutes later with some food. He brought me like 3 or 4 tacos. It was great. It was really yummy because that's all I wanted. So it's time for me and Karen to leave. We get an Uber, and in the Uber, Karen literally goes, oh, by the way, you know that I paid for your tacos? And I go, what do you mean? So what happened was, they went to the taco truck. Kentucky ordered 3 tacos for myself, ordered himself something, and then when it was time to pay, stepped back and looked at Karen expectantly. So she's just telling me how she was so surprised and just taken aback by what he was doing that she felt uncomfortable, like any normal person in that situation. She was just like, oh, okay. And like paid for it, I guess, like paid for my food and his food. So again, I'm just like, why? I don't get, like, you can't even be bothered to spend $3 on me. And like, on top of that, to have the audacity to have someone else pay for your food, not even asking, not even being like, hey, forgot my wallet or whatever, can you cover me? He pulled the same trick he did on her as well. Another time, we went to a Japanese restaurant for some sushi, and my friend Karen only recently told me about this because I had no idea. So basically, we ate, and Karen and her guy, they would pay for each other, they would cover each other, whatever. So I think what happened that day when we went to the Japanese restaurant was Karen paid for herself and her guy. And apparently I didn't know this, but basically Karen's guy slipped Kentucky his debit card, because again, I didn't know this at that point. Kentucky was broke, he had no money. So his friend slid him his credit card so he could pay for his meal. The waiter comes and Kentucky puts down his card. I only have cash. So I remember saying to Kentucky, oh, like I think my meal was about $25. I only had two 20s. So I said to Kentucky, oh, can you tell the waiter to just split it evenly? Cause obviously like, I don't want to pay for you. But I wasn't expecting him to pay for me either. But again, I didn't know that the debit card on the table wasn't even his. So I was just like, oh, can you tell the waiter to split it evenly? The total amount for mine and his food was $47. So I put down 40, but I was like having a conversation with one of our other friends, so I was distracted. So I just said, oh, when the waiter comes, can you tell him to like split it so I can get change back, obviously. The waiter comes back, all my money is gone. I look at the receipt, only $7 got charged to the card and I paid for everything else. And I'm just like, why didn't you tell the waiter what I said? But again, like, I didn't know that that wasn't even his card. So your friend gave you money so that you could pay for yourself, but you made me pay for you yet again. But again, we're in a group of people that I don't know very well. Like, we all hang out with their friends and I don't want to make a fuss and I don't want to embarrass anyone. Ugh, there was just so many instances where he would do that, where like, genuinely, if I listed off every single time he did something like that, this video would be like an hour long. That's how much of a mug I was. Turns out later, Karen's guy tells us that Kentucky is completely broke. He came to LA thinking that he would get a modeling job straight away because he came to model. I don't even know what he came to do, but basically he came to LA to get big or whatever. What do you expect? Like, there's some people who come to LA, live there for years and don't catch a break. What makes you think that you're gonna come to LA, be there for a couple of weeks and get big straight away and start earning money? Like, no, you need to get a part-time job. Like, the amount of times I would go to a bar and there'd be actors or models working their part-time job to afford to live so they don't have to leech off of other people. But that's not what Kentucky was doing. He lived off his savings. What I later found out was he blew all his cash, didn't even have enough money for rent anymore, but he was living at the house illegally. The landlord threatened him and said that they were gonna call the police on him because he wasn't allowed to live there. But obviously, because I was, I don't wanna say loved up, but like infatuated with him and the idea of him and the fact that, oh my God, there's someone who likes me, I guess I willingly ignored those signs. I think a lot of girls, guys as well, I guess, guys and girls, we just kind of ignore the warning signs because you want the good things that they do to outshine the bad things that they do, even though if anything it should be like a balanced thing. And if I'd actually looked at things balanced out, I would have seen that he was literally just using me. And that's the thing, so because of past experiences, I sometimes find it really hard to kind of distinguish what's real and what's my anxiety talking to me. And that's another thing, so he had never been abroad and he doesn't have a passport, and he was literally just like, once you leave and once I have time, I will literally apply for a passport to come and see you. I can't even get a guy that I fancy to message me back, and now there's a guy who's willing to like cross the ocean to come and see me in England, you know? So I felt very loved. But now I know that that whole thing had bad intention as well, because basically by the time you see this video, I'll be in Bermuda. And basically we invited him to come and see me in Bermuda because it's not that far away from America. And one day he messaged me and he was like, hey, so what's the deal about accommodation and stuff? Like, where are we staying? And at that point, me and the friends I'm going with had already paid for an Airbnb. I don't know about you, but to me, it's just like when someone invites me to come and visit a beautiful island, I would at least offer to pay for accommodation, you know, especially if I've been working for a couple weeks at this point. And so when I said, oh, we'll be staying in an Airbnb, he goes, okay, cool. So Karen messages me one day and she goes, oh, I feel really awkward because Kentucky's messaging me asking if he can bring his cousin to Bermuda, and I just feel a bit weird about it. What is wrong with this boy? Like, how do you have the audacity to, first of all, not offer to pay for an Airbnb? And then on top of that, like, he's a plus one. You plus ones don't get plus ones. So yeah, if you're dating a guy who kind of sounds like Kentucky, run. don't do what I did, and your bank account will stay healthy. I never thought in a million years that I would find myself in a situation where I was being used by a guy for money. Like, maybe in my 30s and 40s when, you know, I'm sugar mama age, but not at 21. If you enjoyed this, please don't forget to subscribe if you're not. And if you want to follow me on Instagram and Twitter, I'll link everything down below. And yeah, I'll see you next week.